So this is an unboxing video of the brand new Kodak Pixpro SP360 action camera. This is the full extreme kit that comes with every accessible you could possibly want. We've actually got within this box is two separate boxes. One of them is the box with the camera, and one of them is all the accessories for mounting. So have a look at the camera box first. And you find inside this one, you've got your quick start guide, usual bits of warranty information. I guess that looks like a lens cloth, either that or a tissue. Then you've got your micro USB charging cable. This is going to be the battery charger, so you can charge the battery out of the camera. So you don't have to charge it in the camera. I guess you could probably buy a second battery, and it allows you to charge one externally whilst maybe charging one inside the camera. And because we're in the UK, we've got our micro USB to mains adapter. So this looks like it must be the little case, carry case for the camera itself. And the important bit, the battery. The case has got a reasonable amount of padding, so good for chucking in your pocket. A nice little carabiner clip. Rather nicely, we've got our Pixpro branded lens cover. It's quite useful to have one of those, because I'm guessing if you damage the lens on the Pixpro, you can't replace it. And then we've got the main thing, the camera itself, which is slightly odd because when you look at it and as you move it around, the lens in the middle just seems to follow you wherever you go, a bit like one of those haunted pictures you get in theme park rides. This feels quite weighty, and that's without the battery in. Which obviously goes in there. The battery cover just slides on and off, it seems. There we go. And then there's an extra lock on the bottom to make sure you don't accidentally pull that off. Looks like there's only the three buttons on there. Got the button which looks like it's going to be the record button, and obviously an OK button when you're in a menu. Button to turn it on and off and put it into different modes, and a button, I guess, to go into the menus. And you've got your small LCD display to tell you what it's doing. Around this side, we've got a tripod or lighting pole mount. And under here, this has got a slight rubber gasket on it, which I guess helps to keep it nice and watertight, and in there there's a mini HDMI socket as well as a micro USB and the micro SD card slot, and that just clicks in. Got quite a nice feel to that. Size wise, I've got a Hero 3 Plus here, and you can see that it's not quite as long. It's a lot deeper. And it's not as wide. So predominantly the Kodak SP360 is actually smaller than the Hero 3 Plus. And then we move on to having a look inside our accessories bundle. And this comes with every accessory you can possibly want, or at least that they currently do. So this is a large adhesive mount, I think is what they're referring to as the surfboard mount. It's got the ball and socket point there, and a second adhesive point, which I believe is a for you to put a tether to give you redundancy, just to make sure it doesn't fall off. So if this one gives away, you've got the second attachment point. Pack here of some spare bits and pieces. You've got some spare nuts there, and an assortment of replacement adhesive stickers. Here's one of our helmet straps. So this one's got the loops to go through your vented helmet, and then you would attach the camera by screwing it on like so. And I've just noticed that it's got the little hole there, and on the mounts they've got the pins there, and that's to stop it rotating. So you could mount that on the top of your helmet, and that gives you the 360 degree view around this way and over the top. I've got some more of the little ball joints for extending the range and distance that you can move. And they, so if we undo it, that will go in there and then tightens it up. And that's going to allow you to have some movement on how you position a camera. And that's handy. It comes with another lens cap, because you're bound to lose one. So that'll keep you going. Here we've got a suction mount. Again, with your ball socket there. And that's going to clip on by pushing the lever down. Be interesting to see what sort of speeds you can travel at on a car or motorbike, or in, more importantly, a roller coaster before that falls off. So it'd be good to test that out. And we've got our bar mount. So that's going to undo there. Undo those. Ah, that's quite a nice idea, the way that goes. So it slides in there. Although you do need to make sure you slide them both together at the same time and line them up. I think actually I prefer the GoPro version, where you can slide it out but it stays attached so you can swivel around. I think that could be a little bit more fiddly trying to mount that on. And again, your ball mount. A couple of adhesive mounts there. Some tethers. So that's going to be your safety bonds. Ideal for someone where you're going to leave a camera for multiple uses. And you can bond those to the other little one there. So those would lock through there, as well as onto the camera, to give it redundancy. This is what I think they refer to as the quick clip. So your camera mounts on there, and then using this you can click it onto your belt, onto a rucksack strap, onto a head strap, onto a seat belt, all sorts of different things. Just a quick and easy way of getting your camera up and running and recording. Obviously, it's probably not the most secure, so you need to be careful how you use that. These, I suspect, in this airtight pack are the moisture strips that you put in the waterproof housing to stop condensation building up. The fact that they're in this pack makes me wonder if you can only use them once and then they're no good, but it'd be interesting to see. Then we've got the first of our cases. This one being the standard case. So this has got the holes in, so you're not going to want to put that underwater, although the camera itself is splash proof, so it's fine for, I would guess it was fine for light splashing but not for proper soaking or going underwater. And you've got your ball mount there, and the connections look like they'll work with the GoPro style mounts as well. Then we've got another vented helmet strap. This one's at 90 degrees to the other one, so this will allow you to put the camera on the front of your helmet. Then we've got the head strap. So when you use a case, you have to unclip it from the ball socket, and then it clips on there. And looking at the online photos, there's some way that you can have it so rather than having the strap, the camera at the front of your head, you can rearrange the strap so it ends up sitting on top of your head instead. And then finally, we have our fully enclosed waterproof housing. Same ball mount on the bottom, but this time it's got the glass on the top. The buttons extend through into the inside to press the buttons that are inside. And obviously the camera mounts inside. I think these raised bits here are where these moisture absorbing strips will sit in between there. And that, as you can see, is a pretty comprehensive kit to do just about any filming you're going to want to do with the Kodak SP360.